common mentors. I am Aloha Marie Amarito.
I'm Elise.
And I'm Shauna.
Okay. So, you might be wondering, like, what is Moa Mentors? Or maybe you have heard of this before. But Moa Mentors is one of three mentoring programs. This program is offered to juniors and seniors at selected high schools, and they mentor at nearby elementary schools. We aim to help in various different ways.
About the Moa Mentors. Kamuki was actually the first high school mentoring that they started with. When we did start the mentoring group here at Kamuki, the coordinator was Mr. Kawamoto. However, he retired last year, and currently our coordinator is in this room right now, Mr. Russ.
So the Moa Mentors mission is to positively influence elementary school students through life-changing connections with high school mentors.
These are just some table contents or just areas that we're going to be talking about and focusing on. As a mentor. A mentor is defined as someone who has more experience and trustworthy to mentor someone. So there is an application process. You guys are all currently seniors, but if you know any like underclassmen that you think would potentially fit as a role for a mentor, there's an application process that is given now more towards the fall semester. So you could always, or they could always visit Russ or Sophia, who is interested to be a mentor. Through this application process, there's a 6-week training with all of the mentors, and they basically go through the training to prep them to be a mentor towards their mentees. After the 6-week training, they are then to meet their mentee at the elementary school, and they basically have one-on-one bonding with the mentee.
We use this acronym called CAKE when serving our KP. CAKE stands for compassion, attention, kindness, and encouragement. And basically each component results in a wonderful method in mentoring our students, our elementary kids. And so as you can see, compassion is like having patience and being empathetic to your kids, because these kids aren't your usual kids that are always like normal, or like some of them go through issues at home or mentally, and we're just there to be there for them, like a friend, be their best friend in whatever possible way. Another one is attention. It's one of the most important things that we use during our mentoring sessions. We try to have one-on-one time with our mentors because we want to let them know that we're there for them and that we'll be there no matter what, and just giving them all of our attention. And then another one is kindness. Of course, you know, kindness is everything. It's good to express towards the young ones so then they can know what it is to be kind to others and receive that kindness. And then lastly, encouragement. Just some kids don't get enough encouragement in their day-to-day life, so having that one session where you can just acknowledge their accomplishments, or like encouraging them to finish their homework, or like going out to play, it just means a lot to them.
Take care of three mentors within our mentoring group, and we make sure that we're all still still communicate with them and make sure they're still active, along with perform leadership with enthusiasm.
And then this is like why a co-captain is chosen, or like the purpose of having a co-captain. So the first thing is we want people who are committed to the values of Malala Mentors, which is like faith and just having the trait of leadership that's really important to be a co-captain. Usually we pick people who have been in the program for maybe a year or two. Elise is new, but she's amazing. She's doing a great job, and that's why we picked her. Which is tying into why we want people to have a meaningful relationship with their KP that they mentored. Good communication skills is really needed because you're going to talk to almost everybody in the group and with staff and your mentors. And then we want people who are able to fulfill their roles as co-captains, as well as their other roles in their day-to-day life. Future takeaways.
Future takeaways. This goes to the game with water communication skills, organization, budgeting, especially with OPR, bid planning, and the opportunities. We got to build trust and relationship with our younger generation, and opportunities to meet younger children and foster growth to our mentees. Some challenges we had was definitely like when we were event planning, just making sure that everyone knew we're on the same plan and not allowed to do challenges we had, another challenge was like problem solving.
Here's some pictures from our band activity. OG, it's like commonbreaks.org, so you should check it out.